Hey, this is Will Power, and you're listening to the Indy Sports Car Podcast.
Hey, guys, this is Pato Award, and you're listening to Indy Sports Podcast. And is that what it's called?
That's perfect.
Or did I say something wrong?
No, trust me, man. I mean, I can edit all this. It's no problem.
What is it again? Indy Sports Podcast or what?
The Indy Sports Car Podcast.
Indy Sports Cars Podcast.
Nice. Yeah, if you want to try it again, go ahead.
Hi, guys. I'm Pato Award, and you're listening to the Indy Sports Car Podcast.
Are we live?
Yeah.
Welcome, hey everybody, to this thing that you know what it is. So what it is, what it do, what it be, yeah. Missy?
Hello.
What it be, what it do, what it is, Jared?
What up? Shout out to Josh and Greg here already, watching and hanging out.
Tell Josh and Greg to, you know, put down their yam bag and, you know, jump on with us.
They are.
You know what I mean.
They're hanging out here with us.
I'm saying join up Skype and jump into the conversation. I'm saying I want as many people in the conversation as possible.
Oh, no, boy.
I'm kidding.
I don't know if my computer can handle that. It's a couple years old, so it can still handle it all, but I'm waiting on parts for the new awesomeness.
It would be through my Skype anyway, so, you know, it would just be the voices.
Oh, well.
It wouldn't be there.
But yes, this is the Detroit NASCAR podcast.
Detroit NASCAR podcast, faux Will Power. The man that I mean, he came close to making a PR career out of a Twitter handle. I'll give him that. He was Will's
art card out of it.
Well,
in a way,
it still said Indy.
Same way that you and I and anyone else can get one.
It still said Indy Carnation.
Yeah, yeah. Honestly. Anybody can sign up and then pay the large amount.
That's not
of money.
How we got it. I mean. I don't remember seeing them in the media center. Do you?
No.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah.
Although, actually, I have, because actually any hard card will get you into the media center at Indy.
What, even the...
Yep. Any hard card will get you into the media. It may not get you everything in the media center, but it will get you in the front door.
It won't get you me.
No.
Thank God.
Thank God.
Everybody can't be cursed.
Dude, my favorite part of the media center is the balcony.
Oh, yeah. It's nice going out there and just seeing the start-finish line and the pagoda, or you go out the back one and then you see turn four and everyone coming up at you.
Yep. It's pretty hot.
Hopefully we'll be shooting some content from there.
Yeah. Where am I going here? Okay.
I'm really not tired. I'm not.
Who's tired?
I just yawned. So. I'm not tired. I just, you know.
You making everyone else tired, are you? Anywho.
Well, okay. Well, IndyCar Nation itself doesn't cost that much. Depends on what you get. There are the different levels. What I saw. And I mean, if you pay for the highest tier, I mean, you're almost guaranteed. It depends on how many races you go to. If you're not going to any, if you just get the basic one, or just going like to Indy or something, then yeah, just get the basic one, because it has like the member kit. So you, like, from what I remember, you get like a hat and a bunch of other merchandise discounts and stuff like that. So It's good. It's they used to, like, Trackside Online used to do, like, a daily, like, long report that Steve Wittich and Patrick Steffen would do a really good job, really good write-ups. I'm not sure if they still do that anymore, but there it's, if you were to go to a lot of the races, though, you could get, like, pace car rides and even two-seater rides if you're really lucky. Or just go to a track that nobody else goes to.
Yeah. Yeah, there was, like, one lap around. Yeah, I can't believe. Like, yeah, that's pretty cool, man.
I mean, just one lap and just to ride in the two-seater is awesome.
Never got to do that, but Missy and I were able to meet up with Eric Filigaris at Watkins Glen and do a walkthrough of the entire track with his SCCA crowd. That was pretty cool.
Nice. So, yeah, Watkins Glen is a beautiful track.
Yeah, it took us about an hour to get around the entire track. So you really get like a, I mean, you really get a feel for the elevation change that happens pretty much all over the track. That boot, like from where you start and you make that left hander going down to the boot, like from up there to down at the hairpin, that's got to be like 60, 70, 80 feet easy.
Oh yeah, it is a big elevation drop.
Yeah, like TV does not do it justice.
I mean, it's the same thing that, like, Road America there. You come out of turn 5 and you go up that really steep hill to the Corvette Bridge. Or, yeah, to go into the Corvette Bridge. And that is a heck of a steep walk. It's not very long, but it is quite steep. And you see a lot of that at the natural terrain road courses where you get a lot of the elevation changes. And that's what makes a track so great.
Exactly.
But I do believe
I race can concur.
Do we not have races coming up this weekend? I could have swore there's something going on this weekend.
Oh, yeah, something about, like, IMS, GP. No, yes, no, what?
I mean, I don't know. I'm not going anywhere this weekend. I was hoping to be going somewhere, but instead I will be here on Hot Mic, actually, for every single session that I can, except for the morning warm-up Saturday because I'll be golfing.
I still don't agree with the... You know, so, and you were saying, so NASCAR's got their Brickyard 400?
Brickyard 400 is Saturday. Xfinity is racing on, I don't know, Brickyard is Sunday. I was saying correctly, Brickyard is Sunday. Xfinity races on Saturday after IndyCar and also on the road course. So basically once Indy is done, the IndyCar race is done, then they're going to go right into the Xfinity race. And then once the Xfinity race is done, they're going to immediately turn the track around to the oval configuration because NASCAR has to qualify and stuff. And then NASCAR races on the oval on Sunday.
I mean, it's not that big of a conversion, right? I mean,
oh, it's really not. It's moving some cones.
Yeah, I was going to say, like, they don't put any. Yeah, it's just cones, right? I mean,
it's just cones and, yeah, like, moving. Because, like, you got the corner workers and stuff, but those are mostly in the infield. You just have to. It's relatively quick. I can't imagine it taking more than a half hour.
Yeah, because
to an hour.
Because they'll go the opposite direction. So you figure turns what, like 18, 19, 20 will just be cones. They'll take away from turns one, which will, and then turn one for the GP is turn four. So. Yeah, it should take, what, 5 minutes?
Yeah. Josh here says he saw it in 2016, and it's not hard at all.
Not a huge fan that we're sharing a weekend with him, got to be honest.
I mean, it'll be interesting to see. I mean, it's sad that there's no fans, but they also pushed back the Phase 5 reopening in Indiana by, like, 7 or 8 days.
Phase 5? We can't get past Phase 2.
Wait, what's Phase 5? What's Phase 2?
Indoor dining.
I still think it's great for IndyCar. And from what I was hearing by NBC, because they're pushing this hard, that this is could be here to stay. You could see the Indy Grand Prix being permanently moved out of the month of May and into Brickyard weekend.
I almost welcome it, man, because driving to Indy and back twice in 1 month is difficult. It's very difficult.
Yeah, it depends on the team.
No,
sometimes it's really easy.
I think it depends on where you're coming from.
Well, I mean, the vast majority of the IndyCar teams are based in the Indy area. It's really only Team Penske's out of Charlotte and Kirkland and out of Florida.
Yeah, I care about where the teams come from, Jared. I'm so worried about their driving.
You just care so much about other people, Frank.
No,
I know
I
you.
Don't. I care about myself. I'm very self-centered.
Stop it.
Yes, I am. Mm-hmm. Thank you, Chip. I'm just saying, yeah, the past, like, this will be the first GP we miss live. So
I haven't missed a race at Indy in many years.
Yeah, you know, I was looking for the video that I have of who was the pole sitter? Was that Saavedra?
Sebastian Saavedra.
Yeah.
And what was the first and only standing start?
Yeah, I have the videotape of us. We, because we got tickets to it, though, and we were at turn one in the second row, and you know, I videotaped them, you know, lining up, then them taking off, and the whole carnage that happened. Yeah, everybody missed everybody except for the very last car.
Yeah.
It was
they didn't expect that.
Yeah, it was what
someone else.
Yeah.
Thought it was
no, sense. It was the Ruski who
Alotian.
Yeah, Alotian. But I mean, in Alotian's defense, I believe it was EJ Viso who nudged Saavedra to the right, and if he didn't do that, you know, the Russian would have got past him, but because he nudged him more in towards the inside corner, it was just thankfully it was okay, but that was wow, what a crash.
Wasn't that Saavedra's first and only pole?
Yeah, I don't remember him getting a pole any other time.
Yeah.
I mean, wasn't he like one of the only drivers that actually had some sort of a history with a stand or like the GP there? That's wasn't he part of an F1? No, maybe it was F2 or F3 back like, you know, like 10 years earlier. I could be wrong. I probably am. I'm making all that up, by the way.
But it's actually going to be a pretty busy weekend all around. Yeah, Montoya raced at the Indy Grand Prix back when he could just barely squeeze into the cockpit.
Yep. Yeah, now look at the car he needs. Next, he'll be racing, you know, luxury limousines.
Hey, I saw couple years ago, or maybe it was last year, Belle Isle driving to the track a stretch Corvette. And I thought to myself, how much do I have to pay to drive that?
How much do I need to have to be able to buy it, chop it in half, and extend it? Because that's if you screw up.
Oh yeah, it was pretty long, but just seeing it on the highway, like it was like a heavy rubber neck. Like all I could do is just like, oh, whoa, that's awesome.
Yeah. But yeah, I mean, you know, speaking of you said Corvette officially pulled out of the 24-hour of Le Mans. Just as of like 2 days ago.
Yeah, doesn't surprise me. I wouldn't be surprised to see a lot of
Porsche already did it. So that and now Corvette is gone.
And pandemic's just cutting budgets left and right, and motorsports is usually one of the first on the chopping block because it's more a lot of executives consider it more marketing than research and development, and that's the sad truth of it nowadays. I wish there was more research and development that car companies could get out of racing that would help, like, spur a new technological revolution in cars. Because racing has always been where new technologies are proven, whether good or bad. I mean, you see the good side of things, and then you see like the Mazda and the Sky Active Diesel technology in IMSA that they tried for a few years. And while it was, if it would have worked, it was an amazing concept. It was just too hard to maintain the reliability.
Indeed. Indeed, indeed. I mean, and it's just, I mean, you know, you know, companies are just downsizing to the point of skeleton crews just to run what they can, since they're not full speed, and that's just going to have a huge impact on everything. S rolls downhill, right? So
exactly.
You know, I mean, do you think this will have a gigantic impact on the 2022 chassis?
And I wouldn't be surprised to see everything get pushed back by at least a year. I know everything, they keep saying that everything's on some sort of track, but there's no way that a disruption of this magnitude doesn't trickle its way down into that process.
Yeah. Throughout recorded history, there's never been a pandemic or global pandemic that's only lasted a half a year or a year. It's on average 3 to 6 years, guys. Just saying. So, if everybody thinks that it'll be over by winter, no. It might be over by the middle of this decade, maybe. So get used to how things are.
Yeah. Well, back to IndyCar.
Yes.
So the GP this weekend, is there any? There's a lot of pink cars. Pink and gray this weekend, or pink, gray, and black, but a lot of pink.
Yeah. It's a big, one of the big stories is Meyer Shank Racing. They're going to be doing double duty because they're going to be both, they're going to do the Indy Grand Prix there with Jack Harvey, and then immediately hop on a plane and go down for the IMSA race at Daytona.
Michael Shank's going to do his duty.
Yep.
So let's see, racing duty this weekend is the usual. Looks like Joseph Newgarden, Charlie Kimball, Pato O'Ward, Oliver Askew, Marcus Ericsson, Scott Dixon, Felix Rosenquist, Will Power, Dalton Collette.
Yeah, Dalton Collette gets to make his IndyCar debut.
Oh, did I say AJ Foyt?
Oh, he had some money, huh?
Graham Rahal, Santino Ferrucci, Connor Daly, Ryan SVK, Simon Paginos, Sage Carroll, Zach Beach, Alexander Rossi, Ryan Hunter-Reay, James Hinchcliffe, Takuma Sato, Spencer Pigott, Alexander Apollo, Max Chilton, Jack Harvey, Colton Herta, and Marco Andretti.
Excuse me. I thought I heard you say Sage Carroll.
You did.
Oh! No, I'm kidding. Was it believable?
He's racing for
driver Ryan Bolt. Way to cover right over me, Jared.
Yep. Let's see. Hold on. So I believe it's... Yep. Car number 24.
Nobody can read it. It's backwards.
Well, it's not backwards on the app. But yes.
Yes,
you're right. Your buddy here. We got 26 entries. That is a good number for Indy Grand Prix. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, let's see who's not there and who could have taken advantage. Sage Karam, Dalton Collette, and friends. Just saying.
Yeah. It'll be exciting.
I'll get excited when there's 26 entries full time, okay? For the full season. This is not exciting. The number 26 is not exciting. That's a pay to drive. I don't like that.
I'll take car counts any day.
If that's how you roll, if that's how you swing, yep. I mean, who am I to
that's
judge?
That's how I roll for now. For having such little racing over the last 9 months.
Hey, I mean, you know, and yeah, I mean, they've had plenty of time to save their money, so.
Yeah.
Yeah. Right on.
So it will be Saturday.
Yeah, the first practice. Only practice at 11:30, actually tomorrow morning. That will be on the NBC Sports Gold. And I will be hot miking it for everybody at home who's watching. You can watch along with me.
Well, you said you were going to be golfing.
No, that's a Saturday morning is race day morning. That, like warm-up. The morning warm-up.
Okay.
Come on, Sunday, like, you mean.
Just whatever.
Saturday.
Yeah, I'll be golfing for race that. Race Saturday. I don't care about morning warm-up.
What?
Race is Saturday.
The race is Saturday?
Yes, race is Saturday.
What time?
The race is at noon.
Yeah, it's Eastern time, so 12, yeah.
Noon. Right at noon is a race. Qualifying is also tomorrow at 4:30 live on NBC Sports, which I'll be hot miking it as well. So anything except for the morning warm-up, you will also find me on hot mic here.
No, I don't have off tomorrow.
Getting hyped.
Yeah, I don't have off tomorrow.
That is unfortunate for Frank. I do.
I still get
observe federal holiday.
I do. However, I will probably miss practice. And I'll probably catch qualifying. Because my hobby these days is sleep. It's hard work.
It's a good building a
baby.
It's a pretty good thing to invest in this time.
Yeah, so I'll watch qualifying. Practice, yeah, it probably won't happen.
Yeah.
I'm slightly angry. Why is Missy the big
screen?
You can
just get the gold app. You can watch it on your phone while you work.
Oh yeah, there you go.
Get yourself a Bluetooth speaker, and then you can hear it.
Yeah, because hearing a race is definitely, well, I mean, when you're there, it's good, but.
Yeah, I mean, but, like, if you can watch it on your phone, and then you can also hear it, too. You can hear it better through a speaker than you can through your phone. Unless you're a cheap.
Piece of garbage.
You bunch of POGs. There, everybody knows what a POG is now. Stop asking me. What's a POG? Who's played that? Like, don't worry about it.
Yep. So yeah, like I said, it's going to be a busy racing weekend because, like I said, there's also IMSA's making their big return after everything's. I mean, their last race was Daytona, and fancy that, their next race is Daytona.
Oh, I was about to say, isn't it Daytona this weekend?
Yeah, but it's only, 4 hours? It said 240? Or 220 or something like that? Mm. Some throwback. Someone mentioned it the last time. Yes, Josh, Formula One is back, too. Let's see. Finally get to see Mercedes win again.
Well, no, since Vettel has nothing to really.
That's after the season, though.
I mean, Vettel doesn't have to mind his P's and Q's anymore.
Oh, God. Yeah, that's true.
So. I'm not saying he's going to win, but he's going
to
do everything.
Next to somebody and, like, boom.
Yeah.
Just bump him.
Not like he hasn't done it before.
What? I don't know. He hasn't done that before.
He's a pure sportsman. Through and through. So his apology told me. Just saying.
Yeah.
Ocon would welcome Alonso. Listen, hey, Ocon. You out of touch with reality, non-self-important D. Alonso doesn't care what you think. If Alonso wants to go to Renault, the last thing on his mind is, I wonder if Ocon's cool with it.
Is there any new faces or names in F1?
No, there's not. because we've run out of rich people who love wasting their money on you know, racing that will just basically, I don't know what you're going to accomplish really joining F1 right now, except for being even closer to the celebration of Mercedes's wins, I guess.
I still like Charles Leclerc.
He's about the only one that does shake things up when Ferrari has their, S together, which is, like, rare, it seems.
Well, it's interesting to see here a little story on motorsport.com about Sebastian Vettel. And basically says Vettel was never offered any, never even talks about any sort of contract or anything with Ferrari. They just said, whoop, bye-bye.
I did read that.
That's what you do with Vettel. It's like, you know, a Band-Aid. It's just... It's like, you sure you want to stay, buddy? You sure? Have you liked being on my wrist? No, it's just... into the trash you go.
It's not like he isn't a talented driver. He's just carries a lot of baggage with him. Like, a baggage that would not fit in 17 F1 cars.
Yeah, really. Well, look, I mean, Vettel was just a product of the car that he was in at the time that he was in it.
Yeah, but he has still found success and won outside of that. He's proven that he's more than just being in a good car. He is a legitimately talented driver. You have to admit that.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, it was Red Bull when he won all of his championships and everything. Then he went to Ferrari. I'm failing to see the other team he went to where it wasn't like the number one or two team of the series at the time where he was winning.
Well, he hasn't really gone anywhere else. But yeah, like Greg here says, that a Corvette Racing should pick him up. And then you can call him the Corvettel.
How dare you? How dare you even say that? We don't want him.
And also Greg points out that Vettel did win at Toro Rosso.
Oh my god. The Corvettel. Joke.
You heard what I'm saying?
Oh, good one, Greg. The Corvettel. I love it.
Yeah.
I'm going to get a black magic marker in every vet I see. Where's this?
Don't you touch any of my stuff.
It won't be yours, trust me. So I ain't buying it. Yeah. So I would not. Yeah, I wouldn't deface my own car that way. I'll deface others.
I know what you want to deface.
Anyways, so stop playing with your toys. Anyways, all right. So you went through the lineup for the GP, right? Yep. Look at your stickers.
Sadly, there's no Road to Indy this weekend. They will have their own 2-day event to make up for it. I believe it was Friday or Thursday and Friday before Labor Day.
It's great scheduling by RTI. If they wanted to put themselves in the most prime position to get the fans there,
I'm sure that they got the best that they could.
Right, because it was more important for us to be there during a NASCAR weekend.
I think it's awesome. I'm.
Why?
It's,
why do you think
it's called
awesome?
Trying something different? When you get thrown a curveball, you try something different. We'll see how it goes.
So don't kick RTI to
bomb.
The curb to do
if
it.
Bomb and Frank will be here next week with. Oh yeah, I told you so. Who
it's,
knows?
It's done already. Bombed.
I don't think it has bombed.
I'm excited.
It's going to be a success.
Why? Why does one series? It's only a success, Jared, when you have different series at a venue, when you can go to the venue. It's not a success when it's on TV. No one knows that NASCAR is at IMS when you're watching the IndyCar race, and no one cares.
Yeah, except that NBC has been promoting the hell out of it as a, for the first time ever, IndyCar and NASCAR on the same weekend. Like, it's a first. It is a promotional material. They are working it well. I see it on every NBC channel.
Yeah, and NASCAR fans are going, I don't care.
I watch financial IndyCar stuff all day, and I saw it on CNBC. They mentioned it. So, yeah.
I wonder why they're mentioning it. I'm sure I'm sure IndyCar with a NASCAR is why.
Well, let's just – I can't imagine that if we were still on ABC and ESPN that – we would have gotten even a tenth.
You are totally missing my point. So if IndyCar wants to jump on that juice, then go right ahead. I'm not backing it.
I'm on team positivity. Greg's with me because we're actually taking away NASCAR fans.
This is not team positivity. This is jumping on team, you know, never mind. When did they make this? When did they make this decision? By the way,
months ago, a couple months ago.
Okay, fair enough. So didn't make any sense then either. Okay,
but it's right around the same time that they announced that they were doing the Harvest Grand Prix in October. They said we're gonna do the IndyCar. We're gonna do it on the Brickyard weekend on 4th of July, and then we're gonna do it again in October by ourselves.
Right. Yeah. Hopefully by October. Well, no.
Oh, see, you told me there was no new drivers in Formula One. There is two.
Who's you? Me?
Yeah, you.
What'd you ask me for?
I know. That was a stupid thing to begin with.
I know. Like, come on. We've only been doing this how long? You're going to ask me about something? Come on. You should have called Jared. He'd know.
Yeah. In Frank's defense, 8 of the 10 Formula One teams this year have no change to their lineup.
Yeah, I mean, I'm pretty sure.
And there's only one rookie. I mean, Esteban Ocon is back with Renault.
We wouldn't call him
a rookie,
though. And
then Williams has Nicholas Latifi. Latifi sounds like he's the only rookie
and
this year.
There's a new team. You guys didn't tell me there was a new team, too.
It's probably not a new team, just a new name.
Probably.
AlphaTauri, I think it's a rebranded.
Let's see. Who is AlphaTauri? Who are they?
Italian.
Well, I guess that with the flag they're flying there. Yeah, Pierre Gasly and Daniel Kvyat. Wait a minute. Why is this?
Boy, that team sounds familiar.
Are they Toro Rosso?
Yeah.
Is that Toro Rosso's new name?
Yes.
Yeah.
Toro Rosso is the Italian Red Bull, babe. It literally means Toro Rosso literally means like Italian Red Bull. Or Red Bull Italian.
There you go. It's Red Bull's clothing brand.
Talking to the mic.
It's Red Bull's clothing brand. Thank you, Greg.
Yep.
Do they sell maternity?
We should just have Greg on as like a fact checker. You know, and he can break in, you know, through
Greg.
Yeah, you know, our very own Travis. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Greg, you've been promoted. You don't have to go anywhere. Just keep doing what you're doing.
Also kick Frank in the nuts when you see him.
Well, that's a given.
Oh, you don't need to do that. I can do that for you.
Greg, do not just don't remind her about that. Thank you. All right, so can we move?
I'm excited for our boy Lando Norris. Lando came over, dominated us in iRacing, and then went back.
Yeah, the only thing I can't stand is how he, you know, betrayed his friends to Vader. But hey, he made up for it.
Also, Call of Duty player, so I got to give him credit for that.
Way to just steamroll over my joke.
Cut that part out.
Thank you, Chip.
Uh-huh.
I've only made the joke 1,000 times since he...
Greg, finally I'm promoted. You can take my job, Greg.
Finally I'm promoted, he says. Anyways, all right, so. So, yeah, I don't know. It sure does not feel like a race weekend coming up. Then again, I haven't really slept since Monday, so. There's a shocker. All right. But, yeah. Power determined to avoid becoming desperate for wins. It's really not much. Most of the losses will have not been in your hands, buddy. It's nothing to do with you. It's just. Yeah. By the way, our buddy Josh started his own show. Him and Joey Barnes did their first episode together. So let's steal their topic. Willpower. Should he have more wins than he does? I say yes. I know yes. All right. I think, you know, him and Dixon.
I don't think that's really a topic. The answer is yes. I mean,
that's what they did, so we're stealing it. You hear that, Josh? I'm stealing your stuff. Stop editing and push your stuff out. When you keep editing, I'm going to steal your topic. I'm kidding. No, but for real. Once Josh gets his ducks in a row and everything together, we'll be sure to, you know, give him a shout out and everything and push people towards Josh's show as well. You know, throw him some love. Yeah. So, he's also my guitar student right now. I've taught him how to tune it. And guess what? He tuned it the other day, so we're making progress.
Does he want to buy some?
Well, it is actually kind of, we can pivot into a related topic, a gambling. Looking here at the sports books, try to see who the favorites are to win. And looking here, they don't sadly have any odds here on IndyCar race. But once.
What do they have odds on?
Well, I see. Xfinity race. The best odds so far, Austin
Syndrome. Don't care.
Okay. Formula One. The winner of Austin Grand Prix. Oh, look. Oh.
Lewis Hamilton. Shocked. I'm glad you brought this segment to the show, Jared. It was very... Yep. You failed, son. You failed. Not like I'm doing much better here. I am just, I'm dying over here. I don't know what to bring up.
I mean, it can ease. I mean, I would have won money on my bet from from Texas. I would have put money on Simon to a podium, and that would have got me some good money.
How much if you would have bet?
100? If I would have bet $50, I would have gotten 145. Would have made $95.
Winning 95 and losing 50, it's just not worth it for me. I don't know.
Okay, well, okay, how about this? Bet $500 and then you get $1,450. There you go, Frank. Make $950. Just multiply it by whatever factor you want.
Fair enough.
But I would, if I had to put my money on some people to podium, I'd have Willpower and Simon Pagenaud on that podium. Who's going to be the third? I don't know.
Then again, I'd never take $1,000 and bet it on anything in racing, ever.
That's true. I would. I'd only bet sports stuff in $50 increments.
And it would only be stick and ball sports. Yeah. I'm sorry.
Gloves are stick and balls.
Well, I'm not going to lose money because, you know, some tire changer forgot to, you know, put the tire on. Just saying. Let's just say, you know. Right? Wouldn't you hate to lose money that way?
I would, but that's why I would only gamble with money I would be willing to lose.
I know, but I could convince myself I can lose it, which I can't, but I could convince myself I could do it. And then I can go to AC and do, you know, and play blackjack.
Go to Borgata.
No. I'm going to the Borgata. You know how hard it is to get to the Borgata? It's not an easy casino to get to. You got to go under a tunnel. It's ridiculous.
It is kind of ridiculous.
I know. Tunnels are nuts. It's like, there's a tunnel? No, thank you. That's like, it's like a hole that you drove. There's too much stuff above me. No, I'd rather be on the land. Oh, yeah. And there's a lesson in the physics of a tunnel. I mean I love Elon Musk's definition of a tunnel. Yeah, tunnels are great. You can like keep
love digging tunnels.
Yeah, love digging tunnels, and tunnels are great. Well,
he's also worth a lot of money now.
Yes,
he's done quite well for himself this week.
Just this week.
Quite well for himself. Oh yeah, but, trust me. But he's done quite well for himself this week.
I know he blew up another two starships.
Yeah.
Now we're on to 5 and 6 because 1, 2, 3, and 4 are in pieces.
And his stock almost like went up 50% this week.
It's amazing how the satellite industry is not affected by the pandemic. Go figure.
Yeah. Also, people just buying.
If you have it to buy, buy, buy. Unfortunately, we have...
Buy.
Unfortunately, we have record numbers of unemployment and everything.
Yeah, that's true. If you've been affected by this, which we all have, but some far worse than others.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
I know the feeling. You know how many women are pregnant now?
Yeah. A big shocker. A lot of them got pregnant right around, like, March or so. March, April was when a lot of people start, a lot of conception dates, I'm guessing.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yep.
So I keep hearing. Yeah, that's what I keep hearing. And then I gotta go, no, that's not it. No. I'm not part of that group, no. And they're like, well, what do you mean? Like, don't worry about it. None, just never mind. Don't worry about it.
This was planned far in advance. Before pandemic.
Yeah.
So what's the first race that we're actually going to make it to then? Is there like...
I don't know. I'm holding out hope for Iowa. Not holding my breath for that, though. I've already reached out to
Mr. Williams?
Yes, Mr. Williams there at Iowa Speedway. The great Mr. Williams.
Yep.
Awesome guy. Yeah. I hope everything is well over there, and I hope to be able to go to Iowa. Otherwise, I have more hotels and stuff to cancel.
I'll deal within 24 hours.
Yeah, unfortunately, I made sure to book ones that allowed me to cancel on, like, 48 hours notice. Like, 24 or 48 hours, so that's...
Yeah, that's why you always book through those booking sites.
I will hopefully know, more than a week in advance.
I can't believe you're not booking Airbnb. Or is that because it's not refundable?
Well, that's because I couldn't find anyone. I had an Airbnb at Iowa, and then I was canceled by my host, who said, yeah, no, unless you're staying here more than a month, I'm canceling all your reservations. I'm like, oh, okay. Yeah.
You're not allowed in my basement unless you're going to stay there for a month.
Yeah. Oh, hey, Matt. The old buddy Matt here showing up.
Hey, what's up, buddy? Matty P. You down with Matty P? Yeah, you know me. Who's down with Matty P? Come on. Let me show you what it's all about.
anyway. Yeah, well, back to the racing. Like I said, we got the IndyCar race at noon on Saturday.
All right, great. Let's later that night. Winners. IMSA. Winners. Missy, winners. Give me pole sitter and podium. Well, not podium, but pole sitter and I guess P1 or winner, I guess. Yeah, podium's kind of stupid.
Okay.
Start thinking, Matt and Gam.
Let's see. Winner, I'm going to have to say either Will Power or Simon Pagenaud.
Between what, both?
It's one or the other.
Pick then.
I can't.
Sure you can.
I can't.
It's easy. You go, can't. I'll put Will Power.
They're the only ones that have won the damn thing.
Whoa, language.
That wasn't a curse word.
I know.
They're tied. 3-3.
Okay, so pick one for a pole.
Let's see. Well, pole. I got to go with Will. He's still the pole master. Yeah.
Will loves the pole.
Yeah, it's...
I'm sorry. Low-hanging... That is really distorted. Are you hitting that right, or did you just not record that right?
That's
or it's not turned up loud enough. I don't know. Can we get a chip test?
Go on now.
It's a little bit louder. Do the other one.
Take that out. That's
yeah, that sucks. That recording you need to redo.
I didn't actually record it, but...
Oh, okay. What, there's a chip soundboard
There is program? A chip soundboard.
I'm not, you know, I'm not surprised. Okay. All you gotta do is listen to the podcast for like 10 minutes and record it.
So let's see. Greg Rosenquist, pole, winner Rossi. Oh, do you think... Neither one of those are going to take it this year. It's going to be a completely different winner this year, huh?
Yeah.
I'll go with Will for both. Why not?
That's what I was going to do because, I mean...
Will's going to sweep the weekend.
You don't have to look through the stat book and the history books to see that 3 of the 6 races Will has won. 3 of the 6 races Will has won from pole. So if Will wins pole at Indy on the road course, he's a lock to win the race. The only time Simon won, he won it and was on the pole in 16. Saavedra was on the pole in 14. And last year, Rosenquist.
Yep. Actually, let me see something here. Rossi did some amazing pieces of driving. Make Will spin out that 1 year in the GP. I gotta say. And then, don't mind me. I'm gonna pick Will for the whole sweep. And then what? I think
that's shocking.
I think Matt agrees with me. And Gam, I'm not gonna argue with you, buddy. I mean, I like it. I like it. You know, I do. By the way, JJ coming over to. Coming over to Ganassi to test, I think. When's he testing?
Who's JJ?
Jimmy Johnson. He's coming over to Ganassi to test an IndyCar later on in the season.
Yep.
I can't remember where or off the top of my head. But I mean, unless Chip's going for 3 cars, what is he doing?
He's already got 3 cars. But, yes, it's I can see Chip making room for Jimmy.
As long as it's not getting rid of Rosenquist, because that would be the stupidest move he'd ever make.
He's not going to displace one of his full-time drivers for Jimmy. He will take one of his backup cars, stick a number on it for the weekend... He's and let Jimmy race.
Testing this.
And
weekend.
Jimmy knows. No. Jimmy is not going to wreck the car. Jimmy's too good for that. And like Greg says, it's all PR.
Yes, he's testing this weekend.
Well, sure, yeah, definitely.
At Indianapolis Motor Speedway.
He is testing this weekend.
Course. Yes, I'm looking at the article. Don't tell me no.
I just said he is. I didn't say you're wrong.
No, but I heard a no over there. No.
No, I was saying no. What? I didn't say no at all. I'm done with this. You know, I'm out. You two have a great show. You two, Matt and Greg. You know, I'm out. Matt or Greg, jump in the Skype, take over for me. I'm done. Hanging up. I'm hanging it up. I'm kidding.
Damn. Let's hope.
It is true. Well, I mean, he did it to Ed Jones. So, but, I mean, to Ed Jones' defense, Rosenquist is so much better than you, Ed. I'm sorry. But I like Ed. But I've been saying Rosenquist is a natural phenom for years. And I called it once again. I'm like 9 for 9 at this point. Just saying. See this eye? If you're a driver and you got this eye on you, good things are coming. You're welcome, Pato and Oliver.
Great.
I'm just saying. It's all because of me. Sorry, Parker. I mean, I can only do so much, man. The heck was that? Oh, she popped my head. It's big enough. Right. No, I mean, like, I know I have video of the Savager crash. You know,
back to that again.
Because I have video of it, I can play through the share screen thing so people can see it. You know, the people that are on Hot Mic, you know what I mean? And watch this later. And then what was the other thing?
It's our 3 audience members.
Oh, I know. Screw them. Oh, my goodness. Let's not do something extra for their sake, being though they're here.
I'm kidding. I don't know how many people are looking or watching.
I'm not sure either because I don't know where to look. But, hey, but they're talking. That's all that matters.
We might actually...
Canadian
we might have a special guest Skyping into the show again.
Uh-oh.
Really? Oh.
Yeah.
Oh. Is he on yet or when's he coming on?
I don't know. Let me see if I can get him. Hold on a second.
Good, because I need to run to MP real quick. Can we do like a... Oh, you have Missy? Missy has a big announcement. She's been dying to tell people. I already know it. So, Missy, floor is yours.
All right, tell the guest to call back later. All right, let's do it, guest. Oh, hey, mate. How's it going? Missy?
Yeah.
Hello?
Oh, Will. Hi, Will.
Hey, mate. How's it going? I heard you're pregnant. Congratulations.
Yes, thank you. Yes, we are. Baby Linker will be arriving January 2021.
Oh, awesome, mate. I've been trying to get Liz pregnant again, but she keeps saying no.
Yeah, I don't blame her.
I don't blame her either, but I just want more kids.
One and done.
You see, I did get a boat.
I did see that. I don't know why you need a boat.
That was more for Liz. It's mostly just a shamer. Women don't know how to drive boats. At least not my wife.
Poor Liz.
She loves me.
Yeah, I hate that mustache. Oh, my God. Thank God you
Oh, you don't like my mustache, eh?
No.
That's a real bugger.
You shaved it, right? Yeah, you shaved it off.
Oh, yeah, I got rid of it. Had to. Roger made me.
Yeah, I bet he did. This is why all of you shaved off your mustaches right before the season started.
Yeah, Roger came out of the office, and we all had to shave it off. But Tim Sindrick did give us a heads up, though, when he was coming out.
Mm. Sure he did. Should have buzzed them all along with your eyebrows.
But I'll tell you what, Liz loved it.
Oh, did she now?
Oh, yeah, I give her a mustache ride. I sing, I come from a land down under. Love doing karaoke.
Oh, yes. Oh, I've seen your video.
That's a shame Frank didn't come back.
No, when he probably tripped and fell again.
Nice, it's Will.
Oh, hey, mate. How's it going?
Sorry, didn't mean to keep Will waiting. I had to go to the bathroom.
Well, you know, I was hoping, mate. I getcha.
Hey, Will, what's up, buddy?
Oh, hey, mate. How you been?
Good. You and Missy been talking?
Oh, yeah. Just shooting the breeze.
Oh, yeah? About what?
Oh, I was congratulating about the baby. I was trying to get Liz pregnant the other night.
That's one way of saying it, Will. You know you're supposed to, you know, go in unprepared. Not supposed to prepare for that kind of thing.
Let's go all willy nilly.
Right on. I mean, that's how it has to happen. You got to go in there willy nilly, and then pop, Bo comes out, right? I mean, is that what happened to Bo? Willy nilly, Bo?
Oh yeah, something like that.
Right on. So how is Bo?
Oh, he's great, mate. Did you see I got a new go-kart?
I saw.
And teach kid how to drive. Liz doesn't like that, though.
Why? Does she keep tearing up bottles at home now?
She says that kid will never be a race car driver. He'll be an engineer before I let him drive a car.
It's safer that way. Yeah, yep. So, how's your brother? Doing any comedy spots over in Sydney?
Oh, yeah, he tried, but they tried to shut him down to the coronavirus. They eradicated it, but they still keep telling him that it's the coronavirus.
Oh, poor Damien. Poor Damien.
He's a good chap.
Oh, he's a good chap?
Yeah, he's pretty funny.
Yeah, I think so.
For a wanker.
So, Missy, do you have any questions for Will? Missy, the improv queen.
I or I questions.
I know. Come on, Missy. I mean, it's not really Will. Wink, wink, nudge, nudge.
No kidding. I didn't notice.
Your improv. Okay. We'll take questions from the audience. How about that? Okay. Matty P, do you have any questions for Will? Or Greg, do you have any questions for Will? You know, just spit them out and I'll ask them.
What the hell is happening?
Yes. Will, Matt P wants to know what the heck is happening.
I'm just talking to my favorite chums.
All right. Okay. And Greg wants to know, will this get demonetized? I don't know, Greg. Once I see a dime from any of this, I'll let you know.
I'm going to come to your house and I'm going to take some of your money.
That's about the only way.
Demonetize the franc.
I believe the French did that back in the early 20s. Yeah, that okay. Moving on. Yeah, the franc was a. I'm not going. Never mind. if you know history, that's funny. Okay, moving on. God.
Oh, wait.
Hey, Will. Matt wants to know if that's a ferret sleeping on your upper lip.
Aye.
Why did your mouth move so fast and one thing came out?
Not quite sure.
What?
It's weird how that works.
You're Australian. It's not
technology. Very fancy technology.
Ah, so I was gonna say, just because you're Australian doesn't mean you're speaking a different language, and then translating it somehow. Did you ever fight a kangaroo?
Yeah, I boxed one once.
Oh, you boxed?
Bit of a bugger. Really hard to fight. Put up a good chap. Good fight, though.
Who won?
I don't remember. I just woke up the next morning in a hospital bed.
So the kangaroo.
Probably the kangaroo. You see some of those kangaroos? Dude, they're buff.
I mean, you didn't have kangaroo for breakfast, did you?
No way, mate. I won.
Okay, you won. All right.
Yeah, I won, and then I went to bed and woke up in the hospital.
Oh, okay. Well, I didn't hear that part. Why were you in the hospital then?
Just resting up. I also may have had a broken rib or two.
Oh, is it? Yeah, the kangaroos, they do go right for the ribs. They, you know, they are a body, you know, style boxer.
Yep. Yep. Just went to Outback Steakhouse afterwards and had a little shrimp on the bobby.
The joke is so bad, it's good. Why is your mouth wide open? It's so weird looking. So, did you get new teeth, Will?
Yeah, it's, I went to an English dentist.
I don't know where to go from that.
I do.
You what? You got to pee?
Yeah.
Okay. Well,
I think I hear Bo crying. Liz needs me. Gotta go. Click. Hey,
right.
Frank.
Yeah. Okay. Well, that was fun having Will on.
Yeah. I missed him. I had to go pee.
Yeah. Yeah. Now Missy has to go pee. I guess if everybody's gotta go pee, now's the time.
We did just hit the 1 hour mark, so.
Oh, yes, we did. Yes, we did.
Wouldn't be surprised if other people had to pee. I mean, hours a while to go.
Will Will ever drive for Blue Emu? If Blue Emu ever sponsors another car in their entire history, maybe. But
didn't Alonzo's car have a like an e-cigarette, like an e-cig on it last year? I could have swore. I'm 99% to 100% sure because they actually had a little kiosk thing at Views, V-U-S-E. They did sponsor Alonzo because they had a thing.
Yeah, but it's a nicotine thing. You can't sponsor that here.
Either way, there was. I distinctly remember there was a Views, like a kiosk building inside, like a little trailer in the infield and like the outside the fan village with like all the merchandise stuff where they were giving away samples of vape and you had to be 18 or older to even walk in there. And it was because they were sponsoring a car. It was somebody. I thought, could have swore it was Alonzo.
I don't know. Remember, all I remember is like everybody started running out of the media center because there was some drink. Was it you or was it the party?
That was Rich Energy.
Yeah, that's what it was. Like you started running. I'm like, where's he going? You're like, Rich Energy. I'm like, what?
Yeah, there's
and you just started running and I'm like, all right, I guess we're running now.
I had to have proof that it actually existed. It was for the longest time it was an urban legend.
Yeah, and like I'm just not an energy
I know it's the last thing you need.
What's that?
Energy drinks the last thing you need. It was either Josh or it was DeHardy that was the one that told me last year that they were where to find the Rich Energy. It wasn't hard to find. You just had to figure out which team they sponsored, driver they sponsored.
Well, I know you and I were running, then Josh joined in the running, and then DeHardy was coming the opposite direction.
My thoughts on the taste of Rich Energy, I can't tell the difference between it and Red Bull. I'm pretty sure it's just Red Bull in a different can.
Yeah, I mean, just picture Smarties in some real fizzy water, and that's all it ever is.
But I also have like a SodaStream at home, and they make like an energy drink flavor for the SodaStream, and it tastes the same. So I'm convinced that all energy drinks, like just basic energy drinks, taste the same.
That's because they're all made from the same plant, and people ship them out blank, so they put their labels on it.
Mm-hmm.
You know, just like everything else in this world. You know, that's all I'm saying. Anywho,
I managed to sneak home a can and it sits in my office as a decoration.
I got one too. I have no idea what happened to it, but I do remember bringing it home.
I drank one. I was able to get two of them. I drank one because I had to know.
They gave you two? They gave me two. One. They were like, no, we're, you know, it's, we're on short supply. We can only give you one. I'm like, you just gave him two. And he goes, yeah. Yeah, that was.
I believe mine was taken from me.
By who?
I believe Marty.
Oh, yeah. Marty did take it, didn't he? He goes, oh, what's it taste like? And he just goes, no, I'm joking. Missy's like, here, try mine. I hate it. So don't act like somebody stole it from you.
Jaeger bomb, to answer Josh's question. Favorite alcohol to mix with an energy drink? A Jaeger bomb all day, all night. Except for an Irish car bomb. I could do Irish car bombs until I explode.
I wish you were in an Irish car bomb. What? Ooh. Oh, did I say that? Oops, sorry. I didn't mean that.
Good one, Frank.
I know. That wasn't like just, yeah.
But yeah,
we need ISCP energy juice. Energy juice. I like it. Because I'm allergic to alcohol, so there we go. So, ISCP energy juice, which will be water and a lot of sugar.
Isn't it just Mountain Dew?
Yes. Yeah, I'm all about it. About it.
But, IMSA's, back to the racing, IMSA's Saturday night, 6 o'clock. I planned on doing the hot mic. I don't know. I'm not that knowledgeable on the.
I'll just let you know that I'll be able to do Saturday night. I'll be able to do it with you, but because you know what I thought I might be doing Saturday, I'm doing tomorrow, so I'm free Saturday. But you know, I got to reschedule a side job for Saturday that I had scheduled, which shouldn't be that big of a deal. I might even do it tomorrow. Actually,
I'll be here on the hot mic. If you want to join me, just Skype in, and I literally have a scene that's for just you and I. I just hit the button, and it switches over.
Matt has a light to type, so be patient. All right, so before we jump off, Matt is typing something out for us to read out. So we will wait for Matt to get done with that. And you know, Josh, Josh, you got to tell me when your show goes out so I can, you know, plug it and everything.
Or copy and pasted the link to the tweet of his, but it is on Podbean.
I'm glad you did Podbean, Josh. Very, very good. Very, very good call by you. I'm glad you learned something from this show. No, Podbean is awesome. Greg? As, you know, Greg's always on for everything. You know, Greg was
Racing Radio.
What is it?
Championship Racing Radio.
Championship. I like it actually. Not bad. Not. You know, it that means he can cover all types of different racing. He's not hamstringing himself to one, you know, thing, even though. You shouldn't promote NASCAR ever, Josh. I'm just saying. You know, if you want to keep getting those guitar lessons I haven't been giving you, you know. okay, so some guys I worked with. Okay, so this is Matt. What?
It's a weird name for an energy drink.
What is?
Paralyzer.
Finish reading.
Okay, I'm sorry. Okay, so Matt P. Some guys I worked with when I was younger made an energy drink. Missy, you want to take over?
Jesus.
Come on now.
Oh my God. Some guys I worked with when I was younger made an energy drink mixture that was a big Red Bull in a big coffee cup with a 5-hour energy drop.
Jesus.
In. It is known as the paralyzer.
Yeah, because you're paralyzed after you have a heart attack.
Yeah. Stroke.
I know. Stroke, heart attack, and boy, do you got to pee.
Oh, yeah. You have to do it while on the toilet.
Yeah. That's one heck of a drink right there. Wait, how big one? How much was it? 5 gallons?
It took like a big coffee cup. Fill it with Red Bull and drop it in the shot.
But a big coffee cup is like 30 ounces, though.
Oh, it couldn't have been that bad. He did one a week when I worked at that shop.
Yeah, but like, same thing with me and heroin. You know, like when I first started doing heroin, I could only do a little bit. But now, man, I can just keep pumping it in my arm, man. It's...
Hey, don't make so much fentanyl in there.
The more fentanyl, the better, I say. I could keep on going, and it would be so much worse, but I'm going to stop there.
Oh, thank you.
And all that's a joke, by the way. I've never done heroin in my life with a needle. So moving on.
maybe Sunday morning we can do the F1 race. I think it said like 9:15 in the morning on ESPN.
Yeah, and if anybody, you know, out there listening wants to join us, you know, we're more than happy to have you on.
Yeah. Just hit me up on Twitter and I'll send you a Skype invite. All I got to do is Skype you in. It's that simple.
Yeah, by the way, Jared, I got to... you know, remind me to shoot you over the info for the ICP Twitter stuff so you can tweet through ICP, okay?
I do. I have it on my tweet deck. Like, it's not on my...
Well, can you use it more? You think?
I do.
No, you don't. Like, I always got to retweet you.
I know. But, I don't have it on my phone. I have it, like, it's only on one thing. It's only on my tweet deck, like, on the website. If you want to send it to me, I'll add it to my phone, and then I can tweet more stuff from my phone.
That'd be great, because like the way I look at it, it's not, you know, it, you know, like if I had my way, right, it'd be 70% me, and then be 29% her and 1% you. But I don't get my way, so it's everybody's 1/3, you know. So
yeah,
that made sense. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Sunday morning, we'll wake up and...
made me sound awful.
Have fun.
I'm an awful person.
I know. Mm-hmm. That's why I think they have the replay of it. Is that like noon or something on Sunday?
What, of F1?
Yeah, the F1 replay or something. But that's something you'd want to watch live.
Yeah, because, I mean, literally, let's face it. The first two corner, laps. What track is it?
Austria.
Oh, the Red Bull Ring? Just agree with me. Yes, it is. I know it is. Okay. I know a lot more about F1 than you think.
I can't tell who's driving.
What? What did you just say?
I said you didn't even know who the drivers were, if there was a new driver.
No, I heard you. I just couldn't hear you because you don't know how to talk into a freaking mic. Okay, you can breathe and do it. We're getting closer here. Now make words with that breath into the mic, and you're right there.
Race is Sunday morning, 9:10 a.m.
Oh, it's too funny. I don't know if the visual thing's good or bad. No, but I do like the visual thing. And by the way, you know, I'm just going to take the opportunity to, you know, I want to, you know, yep, Matty P was right on Red Bull Ring, right on. I believe that was the race where Nico Rosberg. Thank you. That was the track where he proved that the stewards will never call a penalty on him as he makes a right-hand turn by using his own teammate to do it. And I would have been somewhat upset about it, but it was Hamilton, so I was like, good. I'm glad.
Was that the race where he, after his post press conference, that was his corner?
Oh yeah. That was my corner. What was he trying to do? It was my corner. Like, I didn't know you could own a corner, but okay. I loved it. That was the only... Yep, Gam got it. Like, yeah, that was the only like that was probably like the last entertaining F1 race I can really even remember. To be honest with you, the rest of them have just been a bleh fest of ultimate bleh. I don't know. So yeah. So okay. So we got our polls, our podiums, all that good stuff out there. Oh yeah, yeah. What I want to say is like you know, the Twilight Zone review has been going really good, and that's on Tuesday nights at 10. If you just want to find all that good stuff out, just go to my Twitter. It's at LLNKZ. Gam's always there, and he can tell you it's always a fun time when you get me and Phoenix and everybody else together. It's a good time.
And whatever, then, they're rats.
Okay. And then on Saturday night, I'm always doing something way off topic radio, live, but I couldn't tell you what it's about because I don't even know until I hit record. So come over and have a good time and enjoy that. And again, you know, Greg has a good time with us as well. So, you know, tell him, Greg, is it not just a whole bunch of barrels of laughs? I mean, is it not? They're always great shows. TZ Review, ICP, and Way Off Topic Radio. That's right, Gam. You know it, buddy. So, I enjoy it. So, there you go. You know, I never seen it with anybody. So, if anybody ever wants to come on, you know, try doing a podcast and hang out, I'm more than happy to have you on. So, at any rate. Jared, any plugs, buddy?
No, just find me here on Hot Mic, man. I'll try to do as much as I can to help just to promote and talk about the sport. So anything racing, I miss Live PD so much.
What? But you miss who?
Live PD.
I don't know
what it is. It's a show. It's a former show.
I was
going to
say, I mean, is that's a very weird name for a guy, but okay.
Yeah.
I mean, it's just, I'll see myself out after that bad joke.
If you want to video into the show, Matt, it's on Skype. You just shoot me a message or something on Twitter and
yeah, it's very easy, man.
Yeah, I just send you my Skype and then you Skype in and I add it right into the video. Otherwise, if you just want to watch along, anyone can watch along here on the Hot Mic app. But if you actually want to be on the show, gotta go through
just Skype, that's it.
Skype.
Yep. That's all.
Oh, God. No, Greg. I hope they never launch Live PC, a live show about PC culture. I hope that would.
Yeah, it's called every other channel.
Yes, it's called everything nowadays.
Honestly, it's everything but Netflix, which, Dark, I can't recommend it enough. Go to Netflix after hearing this and start watching Dark. They just released season 3. Great show, really great mind-bending show. If you have some brain cells in there that still work, this show's for you. You know, it's just not dumb. It's intelligent and it's a good story. And again, it's good acting. So, highly recommend it.
Mm-hmm.
And by the way, and then with everything else with the show and everything, Missy, where can they go?
That would be www.theindysportscarpodcast.com.
Right on. And, I think that's all the plugs. So, I guess we'll have more to talk about after this weekend of racing abound. IMSA, yep. IndyCar, F1, and the other ones.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Back here next week. We've already got our special guest booked for next week. We'll be teasing that out a little later on.
And longtime listeners of the show will flip when they hear who it is, and you'll know who it is right away. So looking forward to it. Really am. It's been a long time coming. Can't wait. All right. So with that one, and no, Greg, don't ask. I'm not going to tell you. It'll be a surprise, so don't miss it.
I'd like to know.
There'll be some mention on Twitter before the show because I got to promote it beforehand, but
not with this guest. I'd say we might wait until it actually happens.
Until it actually, yeah.
I don't feel bad, Greg. I don't even know who it is, so
Yeah, I haven't even told her. I'm going to.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Yeah,
thanks for making me feel part of the show.
No. I wanted you to
already filtered.
I wanted you to be surprised because
we'll
you will.
Just say that the calendar invites have already been sent out.
Oh really? I didn't look at them. Well, they go to your email. You use the Indy Sports Car Podcast
as
your personal
email. That was a it, miss. If you didn't figure out who it was.
Oh, never mind.
Nice one, Jared.
I got it.
Okay. Yay. Yeah. Right on.
It'll be a great show next week. I'm really looking forward to it.
The greatest voice in radio. Greg, you should get that hint. All right. So, Missy,
And on that note, you know that I know. That Frank, I just, whatever. Jared, oh, you know, he's all right. And we're going racing this weekend at the Indianapolis Motor Speedway for the GP, you know?
Heck yeah. Can't wait. Thanks for coming out, everybody.
Thanks for tuning in.
We love you.